From Boston sports to local sports, this is the Dugout Show.
Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of the Dugout Show, and it's just me and Ryland today. So we're first going to talk about the NFL. There's a bunch of news with the NFL. So for the Pats, we're going to have a little debate here saying if Jared Stidham should be the primary QB and Brian Hoyer being the backup, or having Brian Hoyer being the primary QB or Jared Stidham being the backup QB. Now, what do you think, Rylan?
I think it should be Jared Stidham start and Hoyer backup, because Hoyer, he's not that good. He's already had his NFL. We know what he's like in NFL, and he's done. But Stidham, we don't know because he's never played, and he's second year, I think. So
this would be actually his first time playing in.
Yeah, first time playing in the NFL, and I think we should start him because we need to see what he is and see if he's any good.
All right, so that's it for the Pats, but there's two players who still remains unsigned. For example, Cam Newton, and as well as Jadeveon Clowney. They still remained unsigned, so you never know which team they'll be on next.
Yeah.
Let's see. Packers, the Green Bay Packers are going to need a wide receiver. So hopefully they're going to find one, a free agent, maybe an experienced one, or maybe even a new one.
Yeah.
And now both the Seahawks and the Lions are both going to need pass rushing help. That's going to be a biggie for both teams. And then last, we're going to have one more debate. Aaron Rodgers or Jordan Love? Who do you think should start?
Well, I would say Rodgers, because I know he's getting to his end of the career, but you just have to let Jordan Love sit for 1 year to experience the NFL and see how Rodgers develops. So I think you have to keep Rodgers in so that Love can learn from Rodgers.
And I agree with that because, I mean, he's just going to have to learn the plans and see, like, how they can do this play different and that. So I agree with you on that. Now, I believe that is it for the NFL today. So next we're going to move on with Ryland. What do you got next for us in the MLB?
There's not a lot of MLB, but there's the umps that are getting mad because they aren't getting paid any money. I mean, I know the players and the owners and, like, the coaches, they shouldn't be mad about money, but it's the umps. I mean, do you agree that they should be mad that they're getting – that they aren't really getting any money?
I don't, because there's a bunch of other people who are still not getting money, and they don't even have jobs either. So
– yeah.
Or they're being laid off. So, for example, like others, like referees and all those people, they're not getting money. Neither are the coaches or the players. So, I don't think they should be mad at all.
Yeah, I also agree, too, because there are other people who aren't getting paid as well, and the umps probably get paid more. Like, if you were, like, a construction worker, if you were a job that didn't get paid a lot of money, but, like say you worked in a small business, and your business got shut down, so you're not getting a lot of money, and you don't really get that much money to begin with. the umps, they play in the pros, so they're getting money. I know they're not getting any money now, but still, they already had money, so they shouldn't be mad.
Yeah, we don't have any news with the NHL or the NBA. But if I want to talk, I'm going to talk about the playoffs. Because we're not, both the NBA and the NHL are going all the way to the postseason. That is where they are going to start. Now, what are some key takeaways, Rylan, that we're going to start out with the NBA? What are some key takeaways to advance and starting all the way in the postseason?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I just think maybe if the season isn't going to be that short, but say they're doing an 8-game series, right?
Probably, yes.
And so if they're going right to the playoffs and your team loses in the first round, say your team loses the first round, their season that was supposed to be, what, like 162 games?
Mm-hmm.
Is only going to be 8 games. Or maybe even like
16, maybe.
Yeah.
But they're starting out with a short season, and yeah, they just have to learn from that. And that's going to stink for the rookies this year, because they're only going to – they might not even be able to play any game. So they would have to either wait until next year or even play one game in a small little series. And for the NHL, they're going to have to do the same thing as the NBA. They're just going to have to just adjust to a couple games, and hopefully we get to win those. Like, doing good teamwork, like passing the ball to people more often.
Yeah.
For, like, 3-pointers. But going in for, like, layups or dunks. And then for hockey, like, just shooting really well. Just all they're going to need is just a miracle just to get through all the way.
Yeah. I'd feel bad for the teams that get out in like the first round, because their season is basically going to be like a postseason the whole year, because they're not really going to play that many games.
Their season's just going to end in one game.
Yeah. So like, if your team, say your team was really bad last year and you got new rookies who were really good, say you were really bad and the first pick got a rookie, and it was supposed to be really good. Say, the rookie is going to have a hard time learning, since its first year isn't going to be like a normal first year that other rookies have. So that season is going to hurt their rookies, and they're not going to have a big season because their team's not that great.
Yeah.
So it's good to all the really good teams, but the bad teams are going to really struggle for the next years.
And it's also really going to depend on the coaching, how well they're going to do with their plays, like attacking. Like, sometimes they may have to change it up a little bit, and that's okay. That might be good and that might be bad. So they're going to have to do a couple of new things so they can get through a short season. And that's also going to go to the NFL as well, if they can't even play, if they're going to do playoffs or not.
Yeah. I feel like that's also what's going to hurt the teams. It's going to hurt the rookies a lot, because if they don't get a full season, it might hurt their experience later in their careers.
Yeah.
Miami, like, they got a new quarterback, Tua, and he might people say he might turn out to be the next Dan Marino.
Mm-hmm.
And now he might not, because he's not going to get a good experience for his first year, because he's not going to play a full season. If they don't play the full season. If they do, then he'll have a good experience. But also because there might not be fans, too, if they start.
And then with the second season going in, then he'll be like, he'll know all the plays and he'll know how to change him up. And
yeah.
It'll be good.
I feel like if you have rookies new in the game and the NFL changes,
yeah,
I wouldn't start any of your rookies, because it's going to hurt their experience, because they're not going to get a full season. So they're going to prepare for that season. And they're going to get so used to doing it because it's their only season in the NFL. So they're not going to feel like what the full season would actually be like. So I wouldn't really start any rookies. I just keep your old team. Then the next year, I'd start all of your rookies.
All right, is that it?
Yeah, that's basically.
All right, and your trivia question?
Yes. So my trivia question for today is, who won Super Bowl 16? Was it the Oakland Raiders, the San Francisco 49ers, or the Dallas Cowboys?
Okay, and what year would this be?
I don't know. I just know that it's Super Bowl 16.
Right, so Raiders, Cowboys, and who?
The 49ers.
I'm going to have to go the Cowboys.
No. It was the 49ers. They ended up beating the Cincinnati Bengals. Because they had Montana and Rice, and they ended up beating the Bengals.
Oh, they did have them then. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right, then. That is it for the Dugout Show. Thanks for joining in. Sorry it was a short episode, but we were able to do it.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining in, Rylan. And I hope to see you guys next episode. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Another episode complete. Thanks for tuning in to the Dugout Show, and we'll see you next time.